Donald Trump suffering a pair of legal setbacks. A Georgia judge rejected Trump's bid to dismiss criminal charges in the state's 2020 election interference case against him, which the former president argues violates his free speech rights. A Florida judge, meanwhile, rejected Trump's argument that the case accusing him of illegally holding onto classified documents should be thrown out on the basis that they were his personal records and not government property. The two cases represent just some of the legal entanglements facing Trump as he challenges President Joe Biden in the November 5 election. Now let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news making headlines for Filipinos in North America.
The National Hockey League's regular season is winding down, and the Dallas Stars are heating up, having won 11 out of 13 games in March to clinch a playoff spot. They're starting April as the leaders in the West, with a 47-19-9 record. And just as he did last year, Filipino-American wing Jason Robertson continued to shine.
Defensively, analytically, it's pretty good this year. Taking a lot more pride in that and being smarter. And trying to evolve my games in other ways.
In 75 games so far this year, Robo has scored 27 goals and 49 assists. His 76 total points lead the team. However, Robertson picked up the pace in March with 17 total points in the said month. And finally, what better way to celebrate April as Filipino Food Month than with some major honors for several Filipino chefs? The James Beard Foundation has announced its finalists for their 2024 awards. Food Network Chop Champion Nico Hagalanan of Cultura in Charleston, South Carolina, is in the running for the Emerging Chef category. Meanwhile, Quezon Province-born Lord Maynard Liera of Cuyalord has been named as a finalist for California's Best Chef. Tara Monsod of Anime in San Diego is also a finalist in California. In the Northwest and Pacific category, Melissa Miranda of Musang is up for Best Chef. Chris Mauricio of Harana Market in Accord is a finalist for Best Chef in New York State. The winners will be announced at the annual James Beard Restaurant and Chef's Award ceremony on June 10 at the Lyric Opera of Chicago.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.
The U.S. wielding its power and influence over Israel. U.S. President Joe Biden threatening to condition support for Israel's offensive in Gaza on the protection of aid workers and civilians. The White House said Biden and Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu spoke on the phone with the American leader, calling the recent deadly attack on aid workers and the overall humanitarian situation in Gaza unacceptable. Biden made clear U.S. policy will change if Israel fails to implement concrete steps to minimize harm on civilians in Gaza. This marks the first time the U.S. tried to leverage aid to influence Israel's military behavior. Washington's top diplomat also saying an immediate truce is needed.
Here's the current reality in Gaza. Despite important steps that Israel's taken to allow assistance into Gaza, the results on the ground are woefully insufficient and unacceptable. 100% of the population in Gaza knows acute levels of food insecurity. 100% of the population is in need of humanitarian assistance. And those working heroically to provide that assistance are doing so in great peril to their own lives. This week's horrific attack on the World Central Kitchen was not the first such incident. It must be the last. And with regard to our policy in Gaza, look, I'll just say this. If we don't see the changes that we need to see, there'll be changes in our own policy.
This week's killing of 7-8 workers from the World Central Kitchen drew international condemnation, with world leaders calling out Israel's move. With no let-up in Israel's offensive, the casualties in Gaza also continues to soar, with the death toll breaching 33,000. Israel, meanwhile, vows to adjust its tactics in the six-month-old war following the killing of 8 workers. Israel's military earlier called the deadly airstrike an operational accident. A spokesperson for Israel's government also insists the attack was unintended after World Central Kitchen founder Chef Jose Andres accused Israel of deliberately targeting his team.
That it was a mistake that followed a misidentification at night in very complex war conditions. But we are conducting a thorough and transparent examination of this case through the fact-finding assessment mechanism, an independent expert body. In the coming weeks, as the findings become clear, we will be transparent and share the results with the public. So clearly something went wrong here. And as we learn more and the investigation reveals exactly what happened and the cause of what happened, we will certainly adjust our practices in the future to make sure that this doesn't happen again.
Nearly 200 humanitarian workers have been killed in Gaza since October, according to the United Nations. A Hamas official laying blame on Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu for the lack of progress in Gaza's ceasefire talks. Osama Hamdan says Netanyahu has been placing obstacles, hindering both parties from reaching an agreement despite Hamas showing flexibility. Egyptian and Qatari efforts backed by the U.S. have so far failed to achieve a ceasefire. While Hamas wants any agreement to secure an end to the Israeli military offensive, Israel prefers a prisoners for hostage release deal, refusing to commit to ending its military campaign. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu defending his country's retaliation against Iran. Israel has not claimed responsibility for an attack on an Iranian consular building in Damascus this week, which killed Iranian generals. The strike marked one of the most significant attacks yet on Iranian interests in Syria, where Israel has stepped up a long-running military campaign against Iran and groups supported by the country.
For years, Iran has been working against us directly and through its proxies. And therefore, Israel is working against Iran and its proxies, both defensively and offensively. We will know how to defend ourselves, and we will act according to the simple principle that whoever hurts us or plans to hurt us, we will hurt them.
Iran has vowed revenge for the Damascus embassy attack. Until now, Iran has avoided directly entering the fray while supporting the attacks of allies on Israel and U.S. Turning now to the Russia-Ukraine front, NATO alliance members agreed to scour their arsenals for more air defense systems to protect Ukraine from Russian ballistic missile attacks. Overnight Thursday, a Russian drone attack struck residential buildings in the Ukrainian city of Kharkiv and an energy facility in the region, killing several people and cutting power for 350,000 residents. NATO Chief Jens Stoltenberg has not spelled out any specific pledge or aid target.
Investments are just listed from several allies to provide more ammunition and more types of systems to Ukraine. They also understand the urgency of stepping up when it comes to air defense in particular. And therefore, allies will now go back and look into their inventories, look into if there are any ways they can provide more systems, in particular Patriots, but also, of course, ensure that the systems which are already there have the ammunition, but also the spare parts, so they can all function as they should.
On Wednesday, NATO ministers agreed to start planning for a greater role in coordinating military aid to Ukraine to help it battle Russia.